Good morning, class 8 children. Today, after completing chapter number 15, some natural phenomena, today we'll continue with the worksheet, NCERT worksheet number 29, related with the chapter number 15. So your question number 1, A part, take the most appropriate answers. So let's start this worksheet. Question number 1 is, two electroscopes, one positively charged X and other is negatively charged Y, are connected with a copper wire as shown in the figure. Which of the following will happen? Options are in front of you, that negative charge will move from X to Y. So just children, first of all, go through
pushing
this.
From X to Y.
First, X is positively charged, Y is negatively charged, and both are connected via copper wire. As you know, copper is a good conductor of electricity. So what happens? Which charge will flow from positive to negative? Protons will move from X to Y. Negative charge will move from Y to X. Positive charge will move from Y to X.
Negative charge will move from X to Y.
Reason? Why? What's the reason behind it? Both the electroscopes are charged. One positively charged and other is a negatively charged. And both are connected by copper wire. So what can be the reason behind it? Can you raise hand, children? If any one of you know the answer. Yes. Are you understanding the concept or not? Concept is clear, children, or not?
Because negative charge will always.
Yes, tell me the reason for it. What's the reason you are saying? So children, C part, negative charge will move from Y to X. And the reason is that copper wire require a positive charge and the positive are attracted by the negative. That's why the negative charge is moving from Y to X. Question number 2 is, read the given statements and select the correct option. Statement 1, it is easier to generate static electricity on cold, dry winter days than on warm or humid days. Okay, you know that it's true. Statement 2, moisture present in the air carries away charge from the charged surface. So statement 1 and 2, but in these cases, you need to read the statement very carefully. So statement 1 and 2 is in front of you. So just go for these statements. Both statements are correct and statement 2 is a correct explanation. Can I have the answer from your side, which is a best option? Both statements are correct, but statement 2 is not the correct option. Both are incorrect. So the answer will be your A part. Number 3. What is the nature of the electrical charge generated by rubbing two objects?
What is static?
That is a static charge. Next, number 4. Which of the following statement is not correct? Not correct means incorrect statement you have to tell. The lithosphere floats on the mantle. Earthquakes occur along boundaries of tectonic plates. Tectonic plates meet at fault lines. Earth's crust is made up of molten rocks. So you need to tell which one is the incorrect statement. Can I have the answer?
Earth occurs along the boundaries of A.
Anybody else? You need to tell which statement is not correct. Which you feel like that is not correct?
No, the tectonic plate.
Yeh toh theek hai, tectonic plates meet at the fault lines. This is correct. The second option is incorrect. Next, number 5. Suppose you are in a car and there is a thunderstorm. Which of the following is the best way Yes, Tanya. To protect yourself from possible harms.
A part remaining in the car.
Okay, best possible way. Already you have learnt that remaining in the car is the best option. Okay, let's continue with the next part now. Done. Next is, this is Philip. During the development of a thunderstorm, dash move upward. Yes, tell me, beta, those who have raised hand. Neha.
Ma'am, the air current.
Very good. The air current. Let's. Children, write down. Air current. Next. Move upward while the dash moves downwards. Keep on telling me, beta.
Water droplets.
Water droplets.
Okay, keep on writing side by side. Water droplets. Next, these vigorous movements cause, what does it cause?
Separation.
Separation of charges. Next, the dash charges collect near the clouds.
So near the charge.
Positive charge collects near and near the dash of the clouds.
Upper edge.
Huh? What?
Upper edge of the cloud.
Upper edge of the clouds. And the dash charges accumulate. Negative charges accumulate near the lower. Yehi likha hua hai. Kindly mute yourself.
Ma'am, land.
What is written here?
Aavagi.
Tanya, mute yourself, beta. Now tell me, near the lower edge, I may write down?
Lower edge.
Lower edge, you may write down. Okay. Okay. Next, I hope each one of you are doing it. Correct and rewrite the following statements. It is advisable to use elevator to move down fast during earthquake. So, what do you think? Instead of elevator, it will be a staircase. So, you just circle the odd one out and write down the correct one. That is a staircase. Next is, during conduction, the body being charged acquired the opposite charge as a charged body. So what will be the answer? During conduction, what will happen? The body will acquire the opposite charge. Yes, instead of opposite, here will be a same charge. Yes. So, beta, there are the three ways, conduction, induction, and friction, by which the body can be charged. Next, the higher the reading of the Richter scale, the less is the devastation caused by it. Is it like that? Higher is the devastation in caused by the earthquake. Okay. Next is very short answer type questions. Number one, study the given diagram and answer the questions. So the diagram is in front of you. Identify the device in the diagram. Yes, Anshika.
I'm electroscope.
So children, you may write down for the first answer. It is an electroscope. On which principle does an electroscope work? Yes. Keep on telling me side by side. What is the principle? The concept of charges, like charges repel and unlike charges attract each other.
Attract.
Yes, they depend upon this principle. Keep on writing side by side, beta. Already you know that the similar charges, they repel, and opposite charges, they attract each other. C part, what do 1 and 2 in the diagram refers to? So I think you know that already. Number 1, what does it refer? This A part, what is it?
Copper wire.
Copper hanger or wire, you
copper
can say.
Copper wire.
Wire. Next, in second part, what is it? Aluminium strips.
Aluminium rods.
Aluminium strips or rods, you can say. Copper rod honi chahiye, aluminium strips honi chahiye. Okay. Next, what is the role of a metal strips in this electroscope? Metal strip hamare paas kya show karta hai? Metal strip shows, what does it shows? The charges. If it is diverging, then the similar charge is there. If it is contracting, it means the opposite charge it has required. Okay. The role of metal strip. I had told you that when the aluminium strip, they shows the gap. Divergence is there. So it shows that they have acquired the similar charge. So you may write down, if the metal strip broaden, it means it has acquired the positive charge or the similar charge, you may say. Number 2, when and where did a major tsunami take place in India? So you may write down the year and the name of the place. Yes, Anshika.
A major tsunami occurred in the Indian Ocean on 26 December 2004.
Yes, in Indian Ocean, you can say. In Indian Ocean.
Ma'am, on 26 December 2004.
Yes. You may write down everybody on 26 December. Kindly do the corrections. Wherever you want to write in the capital, you may write down. Okay. Next is, name one natural calamities caused by earthquakes. Name some natural calamities caused by earthquakes. Earthquake itself is a natural calamities, but you can name others natural calamities.
Tsunami.
Tsunamis, volcanic eruptions, floods.
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 Landslides.
Landslides. Kindly write down, children. Landslides, earthquakes, tsunamis. Okay, T will also be there. Next is, what are the seismic waves? How are these waves recorded? I hope you know. Already we have discussed in the. Yes, Sanya, you may give the answer. Ananya, Priyanshi, Prateeksha, what are the seismic waves and how they are recorded? Yes, Neha, Mehir, can I have the answer from your side? What's it? And how these are caused? Hurry up, tell me. What's it? This is given on the last page. What are the seismic waves? Harshi Deshwal. Yes, Ananya, tell. Tell what are these seismic waves. Tell fast, beta. Yes, Neha, you may.
Ma'am, seismic waves are the sudden waves that are caused by earthquake or a movement of material in the earth.
Yes, and how these waves recorded?
Ma'am, seismograph. By seismograph.
Yes, these waves are recorded by the seismograph. So, Ananya, you may tell the page number so that everybody can see where it is written.
Ma'am, I have not seen from the book. I have told by myself.
Listen, let me tell you, it is on the last page of the book where the chapter is going to be completed. On the left page, on the top, the seismic waves. Already you have done the definition as well as where, how it is recorded. That is by the seismograph. Yes, next question is, what is a static charge and how it differs from the electric current? Yes, Neha.
Ma'am, static charge refers to an imbalance between the electric charge in a body, especially the imbalance between the negative and the positive charge on a body.
Okay. Anybody else want to give the definition of a static charge? Already, children, this word static, you have read in the friction even. Static friction. Yes, Anshika.
The electrical charge generated by rubbing produce static. The charges do not move in static while charge move in current electricity.
Children, very simplest definition of it. Static means which does not move. The charges which does not move. Kindly write down. Static means charges which does not move. Simplest definition, charges which does not move, that is known as a static charges. And how they differ from the electric current? And you know, the electric current move from one place to another, from positive or to a negative charge. But how the static charges are there? Static charge can be comes into play on rubbing. Static charge, they does not move, but they come into play when that object is rubbed. Aapko malum hai, when we rub the balloon with a woolen cloth, that acquire a charge. When the plastic ripple is rubbed with a polythene cloth, that acquire a charge. Means already the charge is static, but when we rub it, it acquire a charge. Okay. And how does it differ from the electric current? Electric current moves from, electric current comes into play only if charge move from one place to another. I hope this concept is clear to you. And with this, your worksheet number 29 is complete. Rest, next worksheet will continue in the next working day.